it is electric field is there. If you place this dielectric, when a dielectric are placed in an electric field, in this is an electric field, when dielectrics are placed, polar and non-polar, HCl and H2, H are formed here, H plus and OH minus are formed for H2O, you see here. So in the polar means the positive and negative charges are formed in this. If a polar dielectric means if a water is introduced, so water becomes H plus OH minus are formed. So this is polar are formed. The dipoles are formed here. Both polar and non-polar dielectrics developed here. Next question. What is the electric polarization? Question bank. It comes in the question bank. It is very important. What is electric polarization? When a dielectric is introduced, is in the electric field, polar and non-polar are formed. So when a dielectric is placed in an external electric field, a net dipole moment is developed along it. So dielectric is now said to be polarized. The process of making a polar dipole moment is called the dipole. So this is a polarization. When a dielectric is placed in an electric external electric field, a net dipole moment is developed along it. The dielectric is now said to be polarized. So the dipole moment acquires per unit volume is known as polarization. The dipole moment acquires per unit volume. In a unit volume, how much dipole is developed, that is called that is dipole moment divided by volume. So that is the polarization. So it is when a dielectric is placed in an external electric field, a net dipole moment is developed along it. The dielectric is now said to be polarized. The dipole moment acquires per unit volume is known as polarization. So I think this is some more important, but is not very very important. Can be see here. Some important points for CET examination and NEET examination. Electrons are mobile charges in a metallic conductor. In any metallic conductor, you see, electrons are mobile charge carriers. Electrons in any conductor, electrons always mobile. Mobiles moving. Electrons are moving in the charged conductor. Free electrons are free to move in a metallic conductor. Free electrons. If for Fe plus is there, the Fe plus charges. That is free electrons are move in a metallic conductor. Free to move in a metallic conductor. Both positive and negative ions are charge carriers in electrolytic conductors. Electrolytic conductors means in a molten state, electric in a molten state, HCl, H2SO4, like that. In a metallic conductor, charge ions, positive ions and negative ions are charged, that is electron the conductors. Positive ions and negative ions are charge carriers in electrolytic conductor. Electrolytic conductor means it is in a molten state. If you add sulfuric acid to the water, say it becomes electrolyte. In that electrolyte, so metallic ion, positive ions and negative ions are there. So that, example, in a battery cell, you see, it is electrolytic conductor, positive and negative charges are there. So that is in a electric conductor. Electric potential is constant throughout the volume of the conductor. You suppose it is a volume of the conductor, within this conductor, electric field is electric potential is constant throughout this conductor. So these points you have to remember. Once again, I am saying, electrons are mobile charge carriers in metallic conductors. Free electrons are free to move in a metallic conductor. Both positive and negative ions are charge carriers in electrolytic conductors. Electric potential is constant throughout the volume of the conductor. This point you have to remember for CET NEET examination. Next, capacitance. You see the capacitance. Before that capacitance, you have to take some introduction about this capacitance. You have already experienced it. When a motorbike will not start, then what you will do? then just you have to apply the choke. Then you apply, just you press the button of the choke, and then if you start the button, bike, then bike will starts. So that is one example. One example is, if a bike or motor vehicle will not start, then what you will do? Just you press the button of this choke button of the bike, and then bike will starts. That is one example for the capacitance or capacitor. So that you keep that example. Another example, you see the mosquito bat. So what is the use of this mosquito bat? When a mosquito comes, just you will be, you throw it here, and this the mosquitoes will die for the due to the this electric field. So what is this? Not only mosquitoes. If you see a pen, you on the switch of this, and just you keep it here, pen. Then what you see the sparking. So it is very high voltage. If I think that you are, when you are kids, if you have the experience of this shocking, in this, if you put this finger into this, then we get a big shock. So that is one example. You see, keep it that example here, and we can, now by keeping these examples, we switch on to this capacitance. What is capacitance and what is capacitor? We have to switch on this. Not only this, when a lighter is there, for a lighter. Lighter to stove in gas stove to make it to catch a fire, then you are using the electric lighter. So that is a lighter. So that is one example for in the lighter, in the edge of the lighter, spark will come. So you take one example for this. Keeping those examples, we start this. What is capacitance? What is capacitor? So capacitor means. What is a capacitor? Capacitor is a device to store electric charges. It is a device used to store the electric charges. So using that electric charges, the spark will come. So that is the example. In the bike, a spark plug is there, you see. It is a spark plug. If the spark plug will not work, then what you will do? So you remove the spark plug and wash it through the petrol. And then you have to keep the petrol. So you clean the plug by petrol, and then you have to plug it. Then it will start. And another thing is, if you kick the bike, then the wire of this spark plug will give a spark. So that is an example for this capacitance. You see, what is capacitance? It is a device to store the electric charges. Capacitor is a device to storing of the electric charges, is a plus or minus charges. What is capacitance of the capacitor? So the capacitance of the capacitor, before knowing what is capacitance of the capacitor, you take the explanation of this. What is capacitor? Capacitor is a two conducting plates. Suppose this is one plate and this is another plate. Charge this plate by positive charges, and this is uncharged plate. Keep that charge very nearer to this, not touched. It is very nearer to the positive charges. This is positive charges and this is uncharged. We keep this charged plate as it is, and keep another uncharged plate nearer to this. Then what happens? This is a positive charges. Positive charges attract the negative charges, and the remaining part will be, and this side will be negative charges. You see here. So these are the two plates. A and B are the two plates. This is charged positively, and this plate is another. It is brought nearer to this positive charges of the plate. Then the negative charges will be there in this side, and in this side positive charges is there. Take another wire and ground it. You have connected this plate to the grounding. This is grounding. Okay? This symbol grounding. Grounding. This symbol is grounding. And ground, connect this to the grounding. Then remove it. Then this gets only negative charges. This is positive charge and this is negative charge. So you see it. Because you know the reason why it is. This is a positive charges. for any uncharged plate. It is very for uncharged plate, this positive charges attract the this plate and it attracts only the negative charges. Remaining is in this side only positive charges. They connect this to the grounding, then it gets negative charges. Here is positive and here is negative. Two types of charges you can get at a time. So this is also, if you want positive charge, you can connect to the another circuit, take a positive charge. If you want a negative charges, you can take negative charges. Two charges we take it in a suburb, that is simultaneously. So this is a capacitor. Capacitor means it is a device to store the electric charges. It is a device used to store the electric charges. So you see here, this is a positive, this is a device used. So this is, and these are separated by some dielectric constant, dielectric is in between this. So this is, it is a, whether it is a air or when mica, silica, those are there, is a dielectric constant, you can keep it in this here. So define capacitance of a capacitor. What is this SI unit? So capacitance of the capacitor is the charge to its potential difference. Capacitance is equal to charge. This is charges divided by voltage. This is here positive charge, here negative charge is there. In between the positive and negative charges, that is a potential arises. There is a voltage arises between positive and negative charges. So these charges, quantity of charges per that is a voltage, potential difference is capacitance of the capacitor. So define capacitance of a capacitor. What is this SI unit? It is an important question. Capacitance of a capacitor is the charge to its potential difference. C is equal to Q by V, where C is equal to capacitance of the capacitor, Q is equal to charge, V is equal to potential difference. Its SI unit is equal to coulombs per volt or farad. Farad is the SI unit of this capacitance, or coulombs per volt. What is parallel plate capacitor? Just I have explained here. Parallel plate capacitor is a capacitor with two plates, two identical plates are there. Plates separated by a small distance, Yes? The space between them, there is a dielectric medium. So between them filled with a dielectric medium. So parallel plate capacitor is a capacitor with two identical parallel plates separated by a small distance. The space between them is filled by a dielectric medium. So here in between the two plates there is a dielectric medium is introduced. So that is capacitor. So parallel plate capacitor is a capacitor with two identical parallel plates separated by a small distance. The space between them is filled by a dielectric medium. So then explain the principle of parallel plate capacitor. I have explained it here. What I have explained here, that is in the explanation. So this explanation is not important, but you have to know this subject. To know the subject, you have must learn this. So it is very important, and I think it is not given, will not give in the examination, but it is very important for CET and NEET examination. Explain the principle of parallel plate capacitor. You already what I explained. A and B are the two plates. You see, A and B are two parallel plates. A is charged positively. Positively charged plate. A is equal to positively charged particle. B is equal to uncharged particle. B is equal to uncharged particle. A and B are brought nearer. Then plate B acquires negative charges because of positive charge. Plate B is then plate B connected to the grounding. Then what happens? Then B gets only negative charges. Then electrons flow from B to the earth. Then the plate B left with only negative charges. plate B left with only negative charges. So the negative potential of a plate B decreases the positive potential of the plate A. So this is positive potential of the plate A, this is negative potential of the plate B, but it is separated by a dielectric medium and it is not connected here. So that is a positive potential. If we require, we can take the positive charges, and there is a potential arises due to this. If the potential arises heavily, then its spark speed will jump from here to here and it is very dangerous. So what we will do, the dielectric medium is in between them, then it decreases the potential and increases the capacitance. So that is, so what once again I am explaining, A and B is equal to parallel plates. A is equal to positively charged plate, B is equal to uncharged plate. A and B, plates brought nearer. Plate B acquires negative charges. Plate B connected to the earth. Electrons flow from B to the earth, from earth to the B. Here positive charges flow from B to the earth, and negative electrons flow from negative to the grounding to the earth. Then plate P left only with negative charges. So negative potential of the plate B decreases the positive potential of the plate A, therefore capacitance increases. This is the principle of the plates. Next one is, you take this diagram as it is, diagram. Then mention the factors on which capacitance of the capacitor depends. The very important question. It comes in the, it is in 2017-2018 question. It is repeated. So this it is very important. So while mention the factors in which the capacitance of the capacitor depends. The capacitance of the capacitor depends on size and shape of the plate. You see, size, if the size becomes big, then it also, capacitance also increases. Size and shape of the plate. Distance between the plates, the distance between the plate, so this one distance is the plate. And dielectric medium between the plate, there is a medium between the dielectric, so that is the difference. So these three factors, the capacitance depends. The capacitance of the capacitor depends on size and shape of the plate, distance between the plates, dielectric medium between the plates. Then next, mention the method to increase the capacitance of the parallel plate capacitor. To increase the capacitor, to get the more charges, what we have to do? So that is this, increasing the dielectric constant. You have to increase the dielectric constant, because if the dielectric constant is more, then positive and negative dipole moments are arising. So whenever we require, we can get the positive charges or negative charges. So that is increasing the dielectric constant of the material between the plates. Increasing the area of the plates. Area, we take a big area of the plates, we can get a large capacitance. Decreasing the distance between the plates. In distance between the two plates, we have to decrease. When the area, the distance between becomes very small, we get the capacitance more. So that is, you see, that is. These are the phases. So increasing the dielectric constant of the material between the plates. Increasing the area of the plates, decreasing the distance between the plates. What is net charge on a charged capacitor? You see net charges. Here only 8 charges are there. In this side also 8 charges must be there. Because and total charges plus and minus will cancel each other. Net charge always becomes a zero. So total charges of the capacitor is zero. Total charges means net charges. What is the net charge on a charged capacitor? Net charge on a capacitor is always zero, because two plates have equivalent opposite charges. You see, two plates have equivalent opposite charges. What is the value of electric field outside the charged parallel plate capacitor? Is zero. Outside this charged parallel plate capacitor, field is always a zero. So example, you can take mosquito bat. Even though mosquito is on, becomes nearer, so electric field is always zero. Electric field is developed only between the small gap and not outside. So electric field is zero in outsiders, even the switch is on. So electric field is always developed within these plates. So the electric field outside this is always zero. So that one. So what is the value of electric field outside the charged plate capacitor? Zero. Mention the expression for the capacitance of parallel plate capacitor without any dielectric medium. Without any dielectric medium, expression you have to write, and with dielectric medium, we have to write. So the expression. Only I have given the expression. Derivation is in the next period. So without any dielectric medium, C is equal to epsilon naught A by D. With electric dielectric medium, medium is K. K is a constant. Dielectric medium. C is equal to epsilon naught K A by D. So these, where epsilon naught is equal to permittivity of free space, A is equal to area of the plates, and D is equal to distance between the plates, K is equal to dielectric constant of the medium between the plates. So it is very very important question. So it is very very important question. You have to write it in the expected question. EQ means expected question is there. So it may ask in the examination, and in the derivation also it may ask. So it is there. Without any dielectric medium, C is equal to epsilon naught by A by D. C is equal to epsilon naught A by D, and with dielectric medium, C is equal to epsilon naught K A by D, where epsilon naught is equal to permittivity of free space, A is equal to area of the plates, D is equal to distance between the plates, K is equal to dielectric constant of the medium between the plates. Only that's all you have to write it. So all these you have to write it in the notes, and in the memorizing part, with by seeing one time without seeing another time, you have to write it in the rough. Okay. Next one is memorizing part. See, in this memorizing part, each and every question I will explain three times, and by seeing one time without seeing another time, you have to write it. What happens when dielectric are placed in a electric field? Is both polar and non-polar dielectrics developed? Both polar and non-polar dielectrics developed. What is electric polarization? When a dielectric is placed in an external electric field, a net dipole moment is developed along it. The electric dielectric is now said to be polarized. The dipole moment acquires per unit volume is known as polarization. When a dielectric is placed in an external electric field, a net dipole moment is developed along it. The dielectric is now said to be polarized. The dipole moment is acquires per unit volume is known as polarization. You have to write it by seeing one time without seeing another time. You have to write it in a rough. Important points. Electrons are mobile charges in metallic conductor. Electrons are mobile charges in a metallic conductor. Free electrons are free to move in a metallic conductor. Both positive ions and negative ions are charge carriers in electrolytic conductor. Both positive ion and negative ions are charge carriers in electrolytic conductor. Electric potential is constant throughout the volume of the conductor. Electric potential is constant throughout the volume of the conductor. Next. With seeing one time, you have to write it in a rough. Next, capacitance. It is a device to store electric charges. It is a device to store electric charges. Different capacitance of the capacitor. Capacitance of a capacitor is the charge to its potential difference. Capacitance of a capacitor is the charge to its potential difference. Capacitance of capacitor is the charge to its potential difference. C is equal to Q by V. C is equal to capacitance of the capacitor. Q is equal to charge. V is equal to potential difference. SI unit, coulombs per volt or farad. Coulombs per volt or farad. What is parallel plate capacitor? Parallel plate capacitor is a capacitor with two identical plane parallel plates separated by a small distance. Parallel plate capacitor is a capacitor with two identical plane parallel plates separated by a small distance. The two parallel plate capacitor is a capacitor with two identical plane parallel plates separated by a small distance. The distance between them is filled by a dielectric medium. The distance between them is filled by a dielectric medium. Explain you have to write it by seeing one time, without seeing another time, write it in a notes, in a rough. Explain the principle of parallel plate capacitor. You have to write on here to here, you have to write on. It is only understandable, not easy. It will not ask in the examination, just you have to see in this. And this one, main. Mention the factors on which the capacitance of the capacitor depends. Very important question. Capacitance of the capacitor depends on size and shape of the plate. Size and shape of the plate. Size and shape of the plate. Distance between the plates. Distance between the plates. Distance between the plates. Dielectric medium between the plates. Dielectric medium between the plates. Dielectric medium between the plates. Mention the method to increase the capacitance of the parallel plate capacitor. Increasing the dielectric constant of the material between the plates. Increasing the dielectric constant of the material between the plates. Increasing the dielectric constant of the material between the plates. Increasing the area of the plate. Increasing the area of the plate. Increasing the area of the plate. Decreasing the distance between the plates. Decreasing the distance between the plates. Decreasing the distance between the plates. What is the net charge on the capacitor? You write it two times in a rough. Zero. Net charge is zero because two plates have equal and opposite charges. Two plates have equal and opposite charges. What is the value of electric field outside the charged parallel plate capacitor? Zero. Mention the expression for capacitance of the parallel plate capacitor without any dielectric medium between the plates, with dielectric medium between the plates. It is very important. EC is equal to epsilon naught by A, epsilon naught A by D, C is equal to epsilon naught A by D, C is equal to epsilon naught K A by D. C is equal to epsilon naught K A by D. So that is epsilon naught is equal to permittivity of free space, A is equal to area of the plates, D is equal to distance between the plates, K is equal to dielectric constant of the medium between the plates. You have to write it by seeing one time, without seeing another time. You have to write it in a rough and okay. You have to line it. These questions are very, what I have underlined, those questions are very important. You have to learn it. Okay. Best of luck.